Good evening. Myself Rajarajeshwari from Texila American University, an enrollment advisor. So welcoming you all for this particular webinar session. And we are going to see about the cardiologist are in demand and are you aspiring to be one? So earn and learn to become a cardiologist of post-MBBS. So cardiology is one of the most complex field in medicine. They have very high job prospects and are always in demands. And as you know, Health Affairs report showed that the demand for cardiologists will increase as much as in the 18% annual between the period of 2023. Okay, so we're going to see about like cardiology. So as if doctors, you know about that cardiology is a branch of medicine that deals with the disease and abnormalities of the hearts. So there is lots of types of cardiology. So preventive, clinical, invasive and non-invasive cardiology. And we are going to see about what is non-invasive cardiology and what is the future and prospect towards the non-invasive cardiology. So non-invasive cardiologists, they focuses on the detections and treatment of the heart disease using external tests rather than instrument inserted into the body to evaluate and diagnose the cardiac disorders. And right now, when you see the cardiac situation in India is, the World Health Organization report, they estimated that 29% of total mortality in India are due to the cardiovascular disease. And it has been increased by 7% in the last 5 decades. And in the period of 1960 to 2010, from 4% to 11%. And there's a sharp rural-urban divide and 20% have precocious coronary heart disease below 40 years. And the main types are orthosclerotic CAD, stroke, peripheral arterial disease, roughly 6 million cases. And over 80% of the world's mortality from heart disease occur in low and middle income countries. A report from Cardiological Society of India. So they have stated that the total number of qualified cardiologists is only 3,588 as judged from the membership list of Cardiological Society of India. So there is only two society. One is the CSA and Indian College of Cardiology and All Indian Heart Foundations. And the number of cardiac center is about only 200 and it is unevenly distributed and mostly in the southern and western part of the country. The northeast part of the country is poorly served too. So the what are the type of training program we offer in India for cardiology is aspiring candidates, only if you're taking only for MBBS degree, you undergo with 5.5 years. Okay, so after that, if you want to undergo MD degree, if you want to go with again 3 years. And if you want to pursue a DM cardiology, you want to undergo DM examinations, you want to clarify the DM examination, and then you want to go with a period of 3 years of this DM cardiology to become a cardiologist. Okay, so roughly when you say it'll take off around like 11.5 years to become a cardiologist. There are two training programs in cardiology from the universities and from the National Board of Examination. The DM and MCH are given by universities and the DNB in cardiology and cardiac surgery, which is related to invasive, are given by the National Board of Examination. And in India, when you see, we have only this much seat for cardiology. For DM, when you see, we have only 129 seats. For MCH, we have only 207 seats. For DNB cardiology, it is only 72, and cardiac surgery, it is only 72. So you can see here, like total cardiac specialist role out of every year is only 500 approximately. But according to Indian reports, we need of lots of doctors because we are having of lots of cardiac patients in India and there are lots of cardiac institute also in the hospitals and we are having lots of institutes. But when you see the cardiologist doctor alone is only very, very minimum. And the seat also allotted for the cardiology for all these specialties only 500. The total number of death in India due to heart problem is 17.3 million. So what is the career path of post-MBBS to cardiologist in India is? So once if you have done your MBBS, okay, if you want to become a cardiologist, the one option is like after completion of your MBBS, you can directly enroll to a DNB cardiology. Okay, so that is one option. The other option will be you want to undergo with of MD internal medicine. Then after that, you want to undergo a DM or MCH of the examination. And then you want to undergo with DM or MCH of board, where you can be cardiologist doctors. Okay, so the other option is a PG diploma in cardiology or like a non-invasive cardiology, like fellowship. So this is the only option where you want to take to become a cardiologist doctor. Demand for cardiologist. So doctors demand will grow up by up to 3 times higher by 2025. It is report taken by Reuters. Cardiologists are second top paid doctors across the globe. It is report by Health Advisor. And demand for cardiologists in India is the current status of heart disease in India is alarming, with projections suggesting that by the year 2020, the burden of cardiovascular diseases in India will surpass that of any other country in the world. It is estimated that 9.5 million people die each year in India from cardiovascular diseases, amounting to a staggering 31% of all deaths worldwide. 80% of all cardiovascular deaths are due to heart attack and strokes. 74% of urban Indians are at risk of cardiovascular diseases. So there are estimated 40 million heart patients in India, out of which 19 million reside in urban areas and 21 million people in the rural areas. This suggests that heart disease are fast becoming an epidemic in rural area, and structure solution is needed for combating the issues. So where you can see here where the we can have lots of patients in these particular areas. Okay, so the demand of the cardiologist is very high in India, not only in India, when you're looking for even for abroad countries also, the demand for cardiologists is very high. Here you can see this is a remuneration for cardiologist in India. So when you're looking, this is normally for cardio surgery salary. So where when you see normally in surgery doctors of cardio invasive surgery, invasive doctors, so they get a salary around approximately in a year's average of around 35 lakhs to 40 lakhs per year in India. So this is a salary which they get it on. So when you're looking for like in abroad countries, okay, in abroad countries, when you see the cardiac surgery doctors, they'll be getting like more than of like 80 to 90 lakhs per year. So that is a salary remuneration which is going in abroad countries. In India, you can expect like 35 lakhs to 40 lakhs, and it is more based upon the experience and everything. And this is a remuneration for non-invasive cardiologist in India, where in India, you can expect of the salary range coming to 25 lakhs to 35 lakhs per year in India, because non-invasive cardiologist of demand is very high right now in India. So when you're looking for abroad countries, you can expect a salary coming around like of 45 lakhs to 50 lakhs per year, and more than that also, if you're looking for abroad countries. Remuneration of cardiologists globally, when you see American Medical Group Association reports, they said that median yearly income of $5,33,084 for cardiac and thoracic surgeons, one of the highest its salary survey. And cardiac surgeons earn substantial salaries even at the beginning of their careers. Specialty recruiting firm Profiles, which works primarily with new physicians, and reports median first year salary of $3,60,000 per year. So this is a normal of starting salary of a new cardiologist doctors in abroad countries. Okay. So right now, when you see, we are Texas American University in Academic Partnership, University of Central Nicaragua. So we are offering fellowship in non-invasive cardiology course. So as I mentioned earlier, if you want to like become a cardiologist, there is only three options. One, you want to undergo with a NEPG examination, and you want to enter for a DNB cardiology, or either another option is MD internal medicine. You want to clear a NEPG examination to a top score, and you want to get MD internal medicine seat, and then you want to undergo a DM examination. You want to clear the DM examination, then only you'll be doing a 3 years duration of DM cardiology. Okay. The other option is fellowship in non-invasive cardiology. So only these three options is there, okay, to become a cardiologist doctor. So when you see our Texila, this is the only university which provides a cardiology program. Eligibility categories, MBBS with MCA or a state medical council registration. Okay, so MBBS doctors can do our Texila American University cardiology program directly. Okay, and the duration of this program is only 2 years of duration. And the training is complete hands-on training and with dedicated clinical faculties from the hospitals. And we have hospitals all over the locations in India. And as I've mentioned here, you can see the eligibility categories. The duration is of only 2 years, and eligibility is MBBS from a recognized university, should be registered with the Medical Council of India or a state medical council registration. Age, there is no age bar. Candidate with experience in the field will be given a first preferences. And how the method of learning? Okay, so as I mentioned, this is not only a cardiology program, it's a degree program too. Okay, the duration of the program is only 2 years. As I mentioned, like if you're doing submitting a thesis in the final year, okay, so instead of fellowship, you'll be getting a degree. So where we'll be awarding master's in medical science and non-invasive cardiology degree. So we have a two choice. Either if you want to have fellowship, you can go with fellowship, or either if you want to have a degree in cardiology also, you can go with a degree, master's in medical science. So you'll be given a two choice. You can opt of any choice, what degree you are preferring. And method of learning is every student will be guided by the program advisor provided by Texas American University. Student will acquire clinical skills through training in the hospitals and review contemporary articles and concerned specialties. And the requirement is fellowship, submission of weekly report, and case-based discussion, procedural skills, article review, CME, and conference certificates to be submitted for your clinical marks. If you want to have a MMSc degree certificate, thesis writing and viva voce is recommended. An examination, when you see, you'll be undergoing only 4 semesters. Each semester, there will be theory examination conducted towards online, like MCQ type questions. At the end of every year, there will be clinical examination conducted in the same hospital where you are pursuing. And hands-on training, when you see in these, based upon the semesters, you'll be put into the particular hospitals and hands-on training will be provided. The semester one, cardiology wards, you'll be put into that, cardiac ICU and emergencies. In semester two, stress test and nuclear imaging, echocardiography, you'll be put into that particular department in the semester two. The semester three, cardiology wards, cardiac ICU, emergency, echocardiography. In the semester four, cardiac cath lab, only observation will be there and halter. Cardiac ICU or emergency pediatric cardiology. So based upon this particular department only, you'll be posted into the particular hospitals and it is completely hands-on training only, but you'll be practicing directly with the patients. And we have started this program from 2012 and we have like lots of students graduated. So here one of the two students would have been given the feedback about their program. My name is Dr. Hema Gagarwal, and he has done his non-invasive cardiology program from our university only. So according to his feedback, you can see his hands-on training with their affiliated hospitals, and he got a good support from the member who's best in teaching facilities in the hospitals and with Texas American University also, because we will be offering you a student mentor to guide you, and the theory classes will be taught to you by our faculties of Texas only. Okay, so the faculty will be really friendly to you. And he would have said he's personally like thanked towards the student coordinators for the guidance and support. And the other student is like of Dr. Aditya Raghavan. Okay, he also given certain experiences about the hospitals in Narayana Vidyalaya where he was currently pursuing. And not only these two students, just for to show you for the reference, I've shared those two testimonials, but we're having lots of students, okay, who has been graduated and currently pursuing. And the graduated student, when you see after completion of the program, they're working in the topmost hospitals and certain doctors are running their own clinic and they're having lots of patient flows too. And these are the placement details for September 2016 batches. And here you can see of certain students I would have seen where they have been placed in the particular hospitals like NH, Jamshedpur, Narayana Multispeciality Hospitals, Columbia Asia Hospitals, and Associate Cardiologist, and St. Ramesh Cardiac Hospital. So there are lots of students has been got placed with lots of designations, okay, like a clinical cardiologist or non-invasive cardiologist based upon your experiences, you'll be getting placed. And right now, when you see this is 2016 batch, but we started this program from 2012. So from 2014 to still now for 2020, we have students placed in different hospitals with the different designation student has been placed. Okay. And the salary also, which they are getting right now is very high salary, equivalent to an MD doctors. And job opportunity is very high right now for the cardiologist doctors too. And the hospitals, what are the hospitals which we have for the clinical training is, in western part of India, you can see SAL Hospital, which is in Hagamatabad location, Bankers Heart Institute in Vadodara, Sterling Hospital in Vadodara, Rhythm Hospital in Vadodara, Heart and General Hospital in Jaipur. And in eastern part of India, you can see Deason Hospital and Heart Institute in Kolkata. And we have hospital in New Delhi, National Heart Institute, Kalra Hospital, Metro Heart Institute with Multispeciality Faridabad, Yashoda Hospital, Sarvodaya Hospital in Faridabad and Ghaziabad. Southern part of India, Trinity Hospital and Heart Foundation in Bangalore, A.G. Padmavati Hospital in Pondicherry. In southern part of India, Aster Prime Virinchi Global in Hyderabad, Ramesh Cardiac and Multispeciality Hospital in Vijayawada and Guntur, Usha Cardiac Center in Vijayawada, KIMS Hospital in Rajahmundry, Ramesh Sangamitra Hospital in Ongole. So these are the hospitals which we are providing the clinical training for cardiology. Based upon your location and based upon your state in which hospital you are interested, you can take up the program, but based upon the seat availabilities of the hospitals. And program overview, student with basic MBBS is inducted into fellowship in non-invasive cardiology program. And student will be able to procure a world-class master's degree in span of 2 years. The program is divided into 4 semesters. Each semester is of only 6 month duration. And you are expected to commence work on their thesis from the first term onwards, which is a pathway for master's in medical science degree. this is only for a doctors. If you're looking to have only that master's in medical science degree in non-invasive cardiology alone, you can do the thesis in the first term. Okay, that thesis will be guided by your hospitals, the HOD whom you are trained, or by our Texla faculties or student mentors. So they will be helping you towards your thesis. So you can submit a thesis in the final year and you can get your master's in medical science degree. If you feel that you don't want to like submit a thesis, you're okay to have that fellowship certificate. You can go with the fellowship in non-invasive cardiology certificate itself. Okay, if you're looking for fellowship certificate for you, the thesis is not required. And the university is providing the ebook and access to TAU e-library. You don't want to get any books from the outside, where for you, all the reference books related to cardiology, so everything will be shared to you towards ebook format, towards one of the portal. We will provide you one of the portal like LMS, where with user and password to access all your digital library ebooks and our Gaina campus of 4,000 plus library books. So you don't want to get any books from the outside. All the reference, everything will be shared to your portal login. And the student will be guided by our program advisor and a clinical advisor. And student will acquire clinical skills through training in the hospitals. And one of the advantages of the program is you can acquire a wider knowledge and exposure. You can will be given a clinical training in the top cardiac hospitals. And best hands-on training will be provided to you. And the faculty will be really supportive to you while you're in the training. And good learning experience with the dedicated student mentor and academic coordinator supports. Study anytime, anywhere through learning management systems. 24-bar dedicated online technical support throughout the program will be provided to you. And all the e-library and guidance for reference books is provided to you. Articles can be published in international journal. Articles can be related to cardiology. Once you share us the articles that we'll be publishing in international journal with your name and as well as your designations and which hospital you're currently pursuing. And you'll be expertise guidance for the thesis writing also. What are the benefit from non-invasive cardiology program is training, you'll be getting clinical posting certificate from the hospital once you complete the program. And you'll be getting your fellowship degree certificate from Texas American University. And once you submit a thesis with Vivo Voss, instead of fellowship, you'll be getting your Master's of Medical Science and non-invasive cardiology degree. And once you complete the program, you'll get academic completion certification also. The fellowship degree certificate in non-invasive cardiology from Texas American University and clinical training certificate from hospital. After the final examination, student can submit a thesis and attend the Vivo Voss to get a Master's in Medical Science degree. Non-invasive cardiology. So are you waiting for that? If you have any doubts regarding the non-invasive cardiology or about of anything which you want to ask me, so you can ask me right now. Okay, so that I'll be giving you the clarification about your doubts regarding this program. So right now, this is open for that. If you have any doubt, doctor, you can ask me. Like if you have any doubts, you can give with the open, you can have a chat or so that I'll be clarifying your certain doubts, okay, towards this particular program. Okay, if you want to, if you have any certain doubts, okay, which you're not able to ask me towards this particular webinar. So right now I'll be giving you text towards the chat, towards my WhatsApp number and my email ID. So you can come like personally to me so that we'll have a discussion about this program detailedly also. And if you have any friends or any of your colleagues who's really interested to become a cardiologist doctors, but they're very keen to this, you can kindly refer them. Okay, you can share their contact details to me so that I will have a discussion with the particular student who's really interested towards the program. And by referring your friends, you'll be getting off around like $400 as a referral bonus too. Okay, once they have been enrolled to the program of cardiology. Okay, so in the chat, I'll be providing my WhatsApp number and my email ID. If you have any doubts, if you want to ask me regarding the cardiology program or any of the PG program, you can come to me. Okay, so that we can have a discussion personally regarding the program and everything. Okay, so thank you. Thank you for attending this session. Thank you very much.